14th, I'm meteorologist Quaylen Murphy with your tropics update for the Atlantic Basin. That includes the Gulf, Caribbean Sea, and the Atlantic Ocean. Things have been pretty quiet over the last couple of weeks over the Atlantic Basin, but now we're starting to get into some activity and the potential for some activity to develop in the next 5 days. We'll start off in the Atlantic waters closer to the African coast, just south of the Cape Verde Islands. We have an area with a 20% chance of potential development. This is an area that is moving slowly to the west, and we're going to see this potential through the weekend. Slow development, if any, during the next several days. And again, movement west at around 20 miles per hour. Plenty of time to watch this system as it tracks through the intertropical convergence zone. North of that, lots of dry air, so not expecting too much else around that. To the Caribbean Sea we go. Now, we do have a couple of waves out here near the Leeward and Windward Islands. Also another wave closer to the coast of Colombia, but it's closer to the Yucatan Peninsula that we'll be watching as well through the weekend. We do expect an area of low pressure to form over the northwestern Caribbean, with gradual development possible by the weekend. 5 day potential right around 20%. Now, with this gradual development, we could see this system become possibly tropical through the weekend, but it's a low chance. What we're dealing with right now around the Caribbean is a lot of moisture down here. I think some of this remnants of Calvin, which was once in the eastern Pacific. But to the north, over the Gulf, a very hostile environment for tropical formation. Lots of dry air on top of that, lots of upper level wind shear. Wind shear is not conducive for development because it tears the tops off of those thunderstorms, and so they can't get quite organized. However, we expect that we're going to see that wind shear beginning to relax right around the Yucatan Peninsula by the end of the weekend, if not before. And so we could get our area of low pressure developing. Looks like it's going to hang around just very close to the Yucatan until we get into next week, and then we could see that low pressure moving over the Yucatan into the Gulf. Again, the greens and blues representing the wind shear, which will be the case from around the northern Gulf on down through the central Gulf. So again, a very hostile environment here, but we start to see that wind shear weakening closer to the Yucatan Peninsula. So as we go into next week, this will be something to continue to watch. In the meantime, forecast models still agreeable and still showing that consistency with potential development. Even our rainfall forecast catching on to that potential into the weekend and early next week. So as we get into Friday, you can see that we're showing some rainfall developing here around the Yucatan, and then some increased rainfall potential moving into Sunday of next week. So again, this will be something that we'll watch. We're not concerned about it overly at all. Actually, some forecast models begin to take that low back into the coast of Mexico. So something we'll watch in the next 5 days. In the meantime, everything else in the tropics is relatively quiet. Thanks for joining us here online at WDSU.com.